Now we'll be talking about volt second balance in an inductor. And if you haven't seen the capacitor charge balance video, Valerie says you should go watch that one first. The inductor is essentially the dual of the capacitor. It has the same general equation, but the voltage and current are essentially flipped. So we're going to essentially follow the same process as we did for the capacitor and charge balance. I drew a picture of the inductor current, and we did this kind of triangle wave, which is a really common waveform you see in switch mode DC-DC converters. So we're going to use this as our example. We'll start from the basic inductor equation and make a generalization about the average voltage over an inductor. So start here, move the DT over. We're going to take the integral of both sides. Here, we're going to integrate from 0 to t because we're going over one period. This is a repeating periodic signal. So we want to integrate over 0 to t. And we're going to take the L out because that's constant and integrate 0 to t of just 1 dIL. We integrate this, we'll find that this value is going to be IL evaluated at t and then IL evaluated at 0. In this system, again, we're assuming average, steady state. We're assuming the average value is not going to be changing that much at all over time. Then, it means that this value will exactly be 0. Again, this is the integral of the voltage over the inductor over one period. And if this value is 0, it means that this value must also be 0. This value relates to the average value of the inductor. So the average voltage is equivalent to 1 over t. And we just found that if this in the state, average steady state, this value must be 0, which also means that this value must be 0. So that means this whole value must be 0. In a system where the average current is in steady state, the average voltage over the inductor must be 0. The term volt second comes from the integral here. The volt seconds, because you're taking the integral over time, so you multiply the voltage by seconds, this expression, volt seconds, must be balanced on each side, positive and negative, in order to ensure that this value is 0 and that the inductor stays at that nice steady state in normal operation.